Kia ora, ko Sharon Holt tōku ingoa. Today we're going to look at the seasons and the months of the year, and this is a page from our Te Reo Singalong book, which is a picture dictionary. So not exactly a sing-along book, this one, but it's got words and sentences and an app. So this is the page about ngā marama o te tau, months of the year. So that was at the left there, you can see. Ngā marama o te tau. So you might like to put the Māori months of the year on your calendar, or make sure that you know each month what month it is in te reo. So here we have the seasons, hōtoke, and while we're doing this video it still is hōtoke, which is winter. So remember the a, e, i, o, u, and make sure you put a break after every vowel and practice with me pronouncing the word for winter, hōtoke. And then next to that are the 3 months that are winter. So you'll see that there's 2 words for each month. There's what's called a transliteration, which is the second one, and that's always sounds exactly like the month, but with a Māori alphabet. And the top one is not a transliteration, so it's the word that the Māori people gave for that month. So we'll start with June. Pipiri and hūne. So you could practice as well. For July, hōngongoi and hūrai. So hōngongoi looks like a mouthful, but you just make a break after each of those vowels. Hōngongoi, hōngongoi, hūrai. For August is another big one. He, re, tu, ri, kōkā. So as soon as you see a long word like that, you don't need to worry, you just need to put a break after every vowel. Here, turi, kōkā. And the transliteration is akuhata. Let's look at spring, which is coming soon. Kōanga, kōanga. So we've got September, so we've got mahuru, mahuru, hepetema. And for October, we've got whiringa anuku, whiringa anuku, and oketopa. And we've got for November, whiringa arangi, and noema. Let's look at summer. Raumati, raumati, the word for summer. Not raumati, because Raumati is also a place. Raumati. So December is Hakihia and Tihima. Hakihia, Tihima. For January we have Kohitātea. Kohitātea, so I'm putting the emphasis on the syllable with the macron. And Hanuere. Hanuere. For February we've got Hui Tangaru. Oh, I said that wrong. Let's go back. Hui Tanguru. That's really easy to do. So make sure that you're looking at those vowels, like I just said A instead of U. Hui Tanguru. Hui Tanguru. Hui Tanguru. And for February, the transliteration is Pepuere. And the last season, autumn, Ngahuru. Ngahuru. So for March, it's Poututerangi. Poututerangi and Maihe. Here's a hard one for April. Paingafafa. Paingafafa and Aperira. And the last one, May. Haratua and May. So as you can see, some of those words are a bit of a mouthful, but it's a really good way of practicing, and you possibly already have some of those if you're in a classroom on the wall. So it's a great opportunity to practice. Look around for a calendar which has Māori months written on it, and try, you've got a whole month to practice for for each one. Starting, coming up, we've got September starting up, so we could all practice mahuru and hepetema. Ka kite!